A Central Florida woman is suing a local med spa. She says a chemical peel led to a painful skin condition and permanent scarring on her face.
She also discovered the person who performed the procedure was not licensed to do it. She spoke exclusively with News 6 investigator Adriana Ivashinsky to alert others who may have used the same person.
These are pictures of what her face looked like before the chemical peel and then weeks after the procedure. You can see she had painful, oozing lesions covering her face, leaving her with scars even 2 years later.
I had those lesions even on my eyelids.
Daria Sinyagovskaya was horrified when she says her visit to the Cosmetic Institute of Orlando resulted in this happening to her face. She says a relative recommended the place, and when she saw it was affiliated with licensed medical professionals, she felt she could trust them to do a reputable job. So she put her faith in their patient liaison, Catherine Heidman.
When I went to the office, she was wearing scrubs. She was very nice, and she convinced me into doing a chemical peel.
Heidman's bio states she is a registered skincare specialist with over 30 years of in-depth cosmetic industry experience. But DBPR records reveal Heidman received her state license in March of 2017, 6 months after Daria went to see her.
Behind the lab coat and behind the scrubs, you have a person that had very little formal training in working on people's skin.
The DBPR verifies a business needs to have a licensed professional performing any kind of cosmetology procedure, and Heidman's resume shows she had been working without a license since 2011 and had performed more than 1,000 skin consults and facial peels. Before working at the Cosmetic Institute, her resume says she worked for Macy's.
What she has is experience in selling cosmetics, selling perfumes.
So what exactly caused all the sores on Daria's face? A doctor diagnosed it as impetigo, a highly contagious bacterial infection of the skin. And Daria says the doctor confirmed it was a direct result of the chemical peel. She wonders just how many other people have adverse effects under Heidman's unlicensed care.
She didn't tell me anything about the risks.
Daria is suing both the Cosmetic Institute and its parent company in order to hold them accountable for what happened to her. She also wants to encourage others to do their research before allowing anyone to do any sort of procedure on their skin.
If I had known about the risks associated with this chemical peel, I wouldn't have done it.
Now, the attorneys representing the Cosmetic Institute filed these court papers denying all of the claims of negligence and are asking for a gag order in this case. Now, today, they did respond to my email request saying, as a result of this, they cannot comment on the case. Now, there are two hearings set for next month in this case, and the trial is scheduled for July. We will let you know what happens. Adriana Ivashinsky, News 6.
Now, to find out exactly how much training is needed to become a licensed esthetician, head to our website, clickorlando.com. You'll find it under the Investigators tab.